You need on-the-go convenience. Novex Smart Hub delivers. Pay your electric bills, view your energy use, report an outage, and receive alerts regarding your account. With Smart Hub, use your credit card with no processing fees. Level out your monthly electric bills by enrolling in budget billing through Smart Hub. Easily access it through Novex mobile app or at novec.com. You're on the go. Novex Smart Hub goes with you.
Hi, this is Shannon Storms-Bador, Real Housewife of Orange County and entrepreneur. When my company, Real for Real, started selling our health products online, we struggled to ship our orders out quickly and without error. But ShipStation's simple dashboard made it easy to manage orders from every marketplace. Plus, with ShipStation, we get up to 84% off USPS and UPS rates. Automate your shipping with ShipStation. Go to ShipStation.com/audio for a free 60-day trial. That's ShipStation.com/audio.
Showtime. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Are you ready?
Here we go. Ready.
This is the Bob and Jeff Show, starring Bob Lutz.
I have no clue who
it is.
I
a little
am,
different, but when
who
do
you
it,
are,
when
you,
do it,
I
do
you
it.
Even look different.
That can only mean one thing.
Jeff Lutz.
There's Elvis for you. Oh, I'm going to pass out. That was so funny.
You are not cool.
97.5 and 1240 KFH.
What kind of a show are you guys putting on here today?
All right, we are back. Hour number two, the Bob and Jeff Show here on KFH Radio. We are not here tomorrow or Friday. We're giving way to the Royals. They have an afternoon game against the Mariners tomorrow. Then they go to Wrigley Field for a weekend series against the Cubs. They play Friday afternoon. Mike Furches with us for Top 10 Wednesday. He's doing his favorite YouTube channels. Jeff beginning his countdown of his top 100 movies. And I'm going to do my top 10 ELO songs. I'm going to say this about ELO, Mike, and I expect you to give me resistance. Their top eight or nine songs are phenomenal. Then it kind of falls off. Agree or disagree?
I disagree. Obviously, I would disagree.
I knew you would.
I think they have more than eight or nine really, really good songs. So
there you go. I knew you'd disagree with that. And I gave you a chance.
That's his favorite band.
Of course he does. If he said that about the Eagles, I'd go to his house and punch him.
Well, yeah.
Please don't come to my house and punch me, Mike.
Yeah, I do know where you live.
All right, we'll begin with Jeff as he counts down his top 100 movies, folks.
Yeah, number 100 on my list of 100 favorite movies. You know, you got to go back to a time and a place, and, you know, when you're in high school and you enjoy high school movies. One that is kind of terrible now, but still have some good memories of it. She's All That, starring Freddie Prinze Jr., Paul Walker, that other girl. You know who's in it. Usher.
No, we really don't have a clue. I never heard of the movie.
You've never heard of She's All That?
No, not really. Mike?
One of your significant others back in the day took me to see it.
Mike?
It's the bottom 10 of Jeff's top 100, and he don't typically go to movies. That's all I'll say.
What do you mean I don't typically go to movies? I've seen a bunch of movies. I've obviously seen at least 100.
Number 10 on my list of my favorite ELO songs. I hope this counts for you, Mike, because Olivia Newton-John gets a lot of the credit, but Xanadu. Can I get that one in there?
Yeah, you get it in there. I think there's a lot better than Xanadu, but that's Olivia Newton-John. I mean, ELO certainly did all the music for it and did the vocals as outside the lead on that as well. So, and
I
Xanadu's
fully
not a
expect
bad movie.
You to critique this list.
Yeah, and I don't think Xanadu's that bad of a movie either. Jeff Lynne has never seen the movie.
There wow. It is. Max right on top of things.
Max is, I didn't send him this list.
You did not.
Oh.
Well, that doesn't sound like ELO to me.
That's Olivia Newton-John doing the lead vocal.
Yeah, I know.
All right, Mike, number 10 on your list of your favorite YouTube channels.
Well, how appropriate might this be? Number 10 on my list is ELO's YouTube channel.
That's good.
Yeah, and in fact, that's how I found out about the Joe Walsh and ELO concert that they're going to be doing in California what's the name of the town that they're doing it in? Jeff, do you know the name of it?
It's by San Diego. I can't remember where it is.
San Diego, it's near San Diego. But Joe Walsh, ELO, and then there's about three or four other bands that's playing there as well. We'd love to see
Stephen
the show.
Stephen Stills.
Yeah, Stephen Stills is in it as well. So, but ELO,
Flaming Lips.
Panel. Yeah, there's a lot of good. It'll be a heck of a show. If I wasn't working at Santa Claus, I'd be going.
Number 99, Jeff, on your movies, all-time favorite movies list, as you'll be carrying this through the next 10 long glorious weeks.
Well, it gets better. The movies get better. I'm almost ashamed to put this one on, but I can't deny that I've seen it several times. I've always enjoyed it. Unfortunately, it stars Mel Gibson, who disgraced himself. But the movie's called What Women Want.
What Women Want.
Starring Mel Gibson and Helen Hunt.
I think I saw that movie. Very forgetful.
Well, I liked it. What do you want me to do?
That's fine. You can like it all you want. Your thoughts on that movie.
I just, again, I'm glad they're at the bottom of Jeff's list. So I'm not the biggest fan of the movie either. But I liked Helen Hunt in it okay.
Well, that's only number 99.
Yeah, and it's going to get better.
There's a long way to go.
I trust Jeff. It's going to get better.
Number 9 on my list of my favorite ELO songs, and I do love this band. I think they're great. And I'll tell you another band that I love that I think is vastly underrated, and that's Badfinger. And one of these days I'm going to do my top 10 lists of Badfinger songs, and I think people will be surprised at the quality of their work. You agree, Mike?
I totally agree. Badfinger's a great band.
Number 9, Turn to Stone from Electric.
Speaking of
Light
Joe Walsh
Orchestra.
Yeah.
Max can't get that one, though. I'm going to talk a little bit. Maybe he can get the.
Well, it takes a while because you got those YouTube ads. And
yeah.
Yeah.
This is not the Joe Walsh version. Oh, nice. No ads for Max. I like this
Lynn
song.
Produced Joe Walker's
Maybe you
last
could let
album.
It play. Maybe you guys could let it play instead of talking over.
Nah.
How do you like that?
Next.
Number 9, Mike, your list of favorite YouTube channels.
This is a good one. A lot of people don't know about it. Maybe they do. But YouTube movies. There's a lot of old movies that you cannot find on Amazon or Netflix that are on YouTube movies. And there's also a lot of independent, kind of homemade film that's on YouTube movies as well. But it's a fun website, and if you don't want to spend $10 to go to the theater, you can find something there to watch it with the smart TVs, watch it on your big screen TV.
When I get on YouTube, and this has been the case now for several years, I go immediately to Don Rickles on Johnny Carson or David Letterman, and then I go to other comedians on Johnny Carson, and I'm highly entertained for a good period of time because there will never be anything else like comedians on Johnny Carson.
Yeah. The Johnny Carson channel just missed my list. I mean, it's like number 11. It's a great channel.
Mike, I've got a list for you, a YouTube channel for you that you might enjoy. It's called Audit the Audit. It's where it's mostly police interactions where they grade the First Amendment and Fourth Amendment protections that are offered by the courts and the police and everything like that. It's enjoyable. It's real life, too.
Yeah. All right. Number 8, Jeff, on your list of, well, actually number 98, on your list of favorite movies.
There will be several, I think, Vince Vaughn entries into the top 100 as we go forward. We see him first at number 98, starring alongside Jennifer Aniston in The Breakup.
I love the drama you try to introduce.
It's good stuff, right?
I actually did like that movie, Jeff.
It's a good movie.
I did like that movie.
Yeah, that's actually a movie I did like. So.
Well, I bet we have several crossover appeal type movies here. And there's
number 8 on my list of my favorite Electric Light Orchestra songs. And it could be said that this is too low. Mike might think so. Evil Woman. Don't do that.
Hey.
See what I mean?
That was just for you.
That's a good song.
Yeah.
These songs stand up to the best of all time now. Every song I'm gonna mention would probably be in my top 500 songs ever.
Top 500?
Yes. That's how prominent ELO would be in that list.
That's a big list.
How old those songs are, too. I mean, we're talking 70s exactly. And 80s on these songs. Yeah, so.
Number eight, Mike, for you, YouTube channels.
Speaking of the 80s, this page is called Real 80s CCM. That's 80s Contemporary Christian Music. That's the era that I worked in it back in the early to mid-80s. And they play stuff by bands like Daniel Amos, who influenced a little band called U2. And The Alarm, among others. But there's a lot of really good early music that's a part of that era. But the Real 80s CCM channel, a ton of great music on there. Leslie Phillips, who's married to T-Bone Burnett, and I could go on and on and on.
All right. Number 97, Jeff, your list of all-time favorite movies.
First sports entry onto the list, the last, of course, not even the last in this group of 10, Omar Epps, Dennis Haysbert, Love and Basketball.
There you go, Love and Basketball, number 97.
I wish I could remember the name of the actress, and I would if I wasn't so old. Mike, your thoughts?
It's a good movie. I think Love and Basketball is a really good movie. I cannot think of her name either. I would have thought that might have been a little bit higher on your list, to be honest about it, but it still is a good movie, a good pick.
I mean, he's saying, why can't I think of it? He's got a phone right by him.
Yeah, is it that important?
Number seven on my list of ELO songs, my personal favorite, Can't Get It Out of My Mind. Can't Get It Out of My Head either.
As Max looks this up, it's Santa Lathan.
There you go. Thanks for getting that.
You're welcome. Well, you asked.
Starts a little slow, but we get it going. I like that song.
It's a great album.
Number seven for you, Mike.
This
your YouTube channel favorites.
You two guys have probably seen some of the videos off this channel called Playing for Change. And it's musicians from around the world that get together and they collaborate by video, and they all do popular songs, and usually the money goes to help charities and that type of thing. So Playing for Change. And
I have not seen that,
artists.
But that interests me.
Yeah, a lot of big time artists, and one artist will see one, like Ringo Starr may be doing a verse, and then they may have someone else like Jeff Lynne do another verse, and then they'll have just some Joe that lives down in Topeka doing another verse. So it's a real fun channel, Playing for Change, and it goes to help various charities around the world. It's a good channel.
I'm gonna have to look for that one. That one sounds intriguing. Jeff, is it you?
Yeah, I think so. Number 96.
Number 96 on your list of your favorite movies of all time.
This movie's probably a couple elements away from being top 25-ish. It's a little too long. But another sports entry, Dennis Quaid as Jim Morris in The Rookie.
Yeah, I don't know. It was an okay movie.
It's a good movie.
It's okay.
But it didn't fully realize its potential.
Yeah. I would agree with that.
People. It did introduce a lot of people to Jim Morris that would have otherwise never heard of him or not gone into research. I think even non-baseball fans watched the movie, and I appreciated that. And it also gives a little bit of hope for guys that are older that want to go back and give it another shot. So I enjoyed
it. I went
and
interviewed.
It's a great movie.
Yeah. I got to interview Jim Morris when he came to Wichita to speak, so there's that.
Yeah.
There you go. Number six on my list, ELO tunes, Livin' Thing.
Go, Max. I don't know that one.
Max got it.
You like this more than Evil Woman?
Yeah, I do.
There's no way. Someone could sit you down and say, we can listen to this garbage, or you can listen to this Evil Woman. Talk over my songs.
Mike, thoughts on Living Thing being number six?
Again, it depends on your ELO taste. That would be in my top 10 as well. I'm grateful that you're doing this list, Bob. I'm going to tell you, there are special repercussions for this list for me.
Well, good.
It sounds fine.
It's a great song.
My wife, I like it
better than Evil Woman.
My wife and I, we have this agreement. She better be listening to the show today. If she's not, we're going to be listening to the replay. Our agreement is that for every time we hear an ELO song, we have to give each other a kiss. So I'm going to be getting at least 10 extra kisses today.
Sweet. Number six for you, Mike, YouTube channels.
I came across this watching a reel on Facebook, ended up subscribing to the channel, and I have to do a weekly update on it. It's from Club Dirty. Club Dirty, that's the channel. What he does is this guy reviews the mixed drinks, and he'll get suggestions. He'll mix a drink up with various alcohol and non-alcoholic substances and beverages, and then he'll sample it on air and tell you what he thinks about it. I have come across some wonderful tasting, enjoyable drinks because of Club Dirty, and I watch it weekly.
Well, I look forward to you posting this list because there are several of these channels I'm going to check out as well.
Yeah.
So I'm glad you did this list because I'm unaware of a lot of this, and it sounds like I'd enjoy watching some of this stuff.
You'll enjoy Club Dirty, I'm sure, if you enjoy an adult beverage on occasion.
All right, we'll take a break. We'll come back and do top five on our Top 10 Wednesday segment with Mike Furches. Stay with us.
...75 and 1240 KFH.
All right, here's a song from 1965 that did get to number one, The Byrds' Mr. Tambourine Man, with contributions from members of the Wrecking Crew. That's the musical theme this week. Mike Furches with us as we continue with our Top 10 Wednesday. Mike doing YouTube channels. I'm highlighting songs from Electric Light Orchestra. Jeff beginning his countdown of his Top 100 movies. We'll get back to Jeff for number 5, number 95 on your list of Top 100 movies.
Yeah, pretty much unwatchable for me at this point because it's just too sad. But a great movie that deserves some love, My Girl.
Yeah, it's a sad movie.
Horribly sad.
Well, I mean, yeah.
Yeah, extremely sad. Like,
yeah,
maybe the saddest movie ever.
It can't be worse than The Notebook.
I don't know.
Well, the saddest movie ever is Marley and Me.
Yeah. I think Brian's not.
I don't know. That dog and The Notebook people got to live pretty full lives. And my man Macaulay did not.
Yeah, but you can't do that. Marley and Me, you can't do that. Number 5 on my list of my favorite ELO songs is Telephone Line.
It is. Well, I'd love to hear it.
Max is getting there.
Hello?
Are you sure?
How are you? Have y'all been
Maybe
all
Max
right?
isn't getting there.
Through all right, lonely, number five. Lonely nights.
Yeah. I would have loved to have heard that, but I threw Max a curve. There it is. Kind of hokey, but I love the song. All right, Mike. Number 5 on your list of your favorite YouTube channels.
Oh, this you remember Jerry Clower, Bob?
Yes. Yes.
He was a Southern humorist. And today's Southern humorist, much along the lines of Jerry Clower, is a fellow by the name of Milton Crabapple. In fact, I'll post this, and Milton will probably come on and say something. I heard about him the first time I went to Branson, and I subscribed to his videos. He's a Southern humorist telling stories. He's talking about comedians. He'd be a good one to have on the show. He tells the funniest stories, much along the lines, and in some ways even funnier than Jerry Clower did. I love Milton Crabapple, and I enjoy his YouTube channel because there's so many funny stories on there.
Well, we're going to ask you to make it happen that he gets on this show sometime.
Okay, I'll tag it on the post when I post it up later on, and I'll see if I can get him on. He's hilarious. Milton Crabapple.
I'm a fan of getting comedians on this show. I like that.
Okay.
And the last couple of days we've had Brad Upton and Gianmarco Cerisi, and although neither of them is coming to Wichita, I think it's important to highlight comedians. I like doing that. So let's get Mr. Crabapple, which I'm sure is his real name.
Got to be. Crabapple.
He's a sheriff, too. I mean, you have to listen to the story. So for those that remember Jerry Clower, you will absolutely love Milton Crabapple.
Number four, Jeff, number 94 on your list of all-time favorite movies.
Another one of those, like The Rookie, based on a true story that was good. Some would say probably really good. For me, didn't quite reach the potential it had. Well acted. I hope your wife isn't too mad at me. Walk the Line. Number 94.
That's only 94.
Yes.
She'll wonder about that.
She probably will.
I would think that would be higher.
It just wasn't.
That's the first time I'm now questioning.
Well, I mean, I have tiers of my list, and this fell into the bottom tier of the top one.
There you go. Number four on my list of my particular favorite songs from the great band Electric Light Orchestra, Mr. Blue Sky, comes in at number four. And we'll play a snippet of that song for you right now. Here's what I love about ELO.
If that's not Beatles influence, nothing.
Well, everything they do is Beatles influence. Look at Jeff Lynne. He's big time influenced by the Beatles.
Of course.
Well, and he, you could also say he influenced the Beatles. If you look at Paul McCartney, George Harrison, he brought the Beatles back together again.
Yeah. I mean, the Jeff Lynne's right there. Number four, Mike, your list of YouTube channels.
This is taking it back, and most people have heard of them doing one of the AC/DC songs, Thunderstruck, but it's a band from Finland called Steven Seagulls. So it's the Steven Seagulls band out of Finland. They play what I call metal grass. They take songs like AC/DC's Thunderstruck, and they put a bluegrass feel to it, and it really works the way they do it. So Steven Seagulls.
Well, you're selling this stuff very well. I mean, when you say they put a bluegrass feel to, if not heavy metal, certainly hard rock. I'd like to hear that. So I'm going to have to look that one up as well. Number, no response from Mike.
Where did Mike go? Did he drop off?
I think I'm still here.
Okay, good.
number 93 on Jeff's list of his favorite movies.
Kind of a cultural touchstone in the moment it was released, heavily lauded by critics, and that would be Mean Girls.
Mean Girls, which, yeah, okay.
I have to admit, I've never seen it, and I need to see it because I've heard a lot of good things about the movie Mean Girls. So
yeah, it's kind of a movie for its time, but it holds up okay.
All right, yeah. Mean Girls. Number three on my list of my favorite Electric Light Orchestra songs. I love this song. I love them all now. I mean, I love all of these songs.
Certainly.
Shine a Little Love. from Electric Light Orchestra.
You ever get to the?
Oh, you gotta have the, you gotta have like the backward masking all the electronic stuff first.
Yeah, Max could have started it right there, but he doesn't have time. Listen, we're throwing a lot at Max.
He's doing a heck of a job.
And part of the, so good. Jeff Lynne is so good.
Yeah.
And part of the allure of this band is the orchestra part of it.
And the electric. I get it all, man.
Number three, Mike, for you, your favorite YouTube channels.
It's Glenn Kaiser, K-A-I-S-E-R. Glenn is a phenomenal blues artist who mixes in social commentary of things such as homelessness, wealth, and those types of things into his music. But Glenn Kaiser, I actually got to record with Glenn, but his music, he's known all over the world as one of the great blues artists, and specifically because of the social commentary in a lot of his music. There's some religious commentary as well. But no one like Glenn Kaiser. Shane Steele, for those that are into blues music that know who that is, him and Glenn are personal good friends. Glenn is a legitimate Blues Hall of Fame player, phenomenal player, and I love the fact that he includes social commentary in his music.
All right. Never heard of him either. I'm getting an education. Number two, Jeff, number 92, my bad. As we count this down over the next 10 weeks.
Oh, yeah. It'll be
Appointment
fun.
Radio.
Should be.
Number 92 on your list of favorite movies.
The next and final sports entry of this particular group of 10, Whoopi Goldberg starring as Eddie. Eddie.
Never saw that movie.
Malik Sealy was in it. Gary Payton was in it.
Yeah.
Dwayne Shinchus was in it. They had John Sally was in it. A bunch of NBA guys.
Yeah.
Mike, any recollection?
Yes, I got to do the premiere for that movie, in fact, and which was a lot of fun. There were a lot of people there that were a part of the movie. Then they were giving out things like basketballs, signed basketballs by Whoopi and things of that nature. I actually enjoyed Eddie, and I thought it was one of Whoopi's best films. So
it's a good movie. It's a fun little movie.
Yeah, it's a good movie.
There you go. Where are we? Number two for me, my list of ELO songs. I just absolutely love the song. I could listen to it on loop for days. Showdown.
Huh. Get a little live version.
The vocals are amazing here.
I've never done that one in karaoke, which I'm ashamed of, because I think that's in my range.
Yeah.
At least it used to be. We'll see. Number two, Mike, YouTube channels.
This guy here, he did the foreword to my book, but he is the spiritual advisor to Metallica, Alice Cooper, and he founded the band Striper. And he has a devotion channel along those lines that I read every day, or I watch every day, Pastor Bob Beeman's Sanctuary International. And just by the bands that he's worked with and is really good friends with, it can tell you that says something that it's a different kind of a devotion. And I love Pastor Bob and the Sanctuary International YouTube channel, number two on my list. So, and I know that you probably and a lot of others have never heard of that, but Bob has a good following. And certainly the guys in Metallica and Striper and, you know, the band Alice Cooper have had a great deal of appreciation for him.
Interesting. All right, another one to check out. Now we get down to the nitty-gritty. Number one for Mike and I, only number 91 for you.
Yeah, this was a great idea.
I don't know if it was or not. I like top 10 lists.
No, we'll get to top 10 in 9 weeks.
In December.
Yeah.
Number 91 for you, favorite movies.
I'm going to leave them wanting more here because I did say that there were no Best Picture winners. That wasn't really my style. But this movie did win Best Picture, and it is number 91. It is Titanic.
Seems low.
Titanic.
Yeah.
Seems low.
It does seem a little low. I agree with you. But
you got 90,
I like the other movies better.
If you've got 90 pictures that you've actually seen that are, you know, better than Titanic, that's been more about you than I thought, Jeff. That's, you know, more about pop culture than you give yourself credit for.
You might not agree, Mike, but I like Titanic a lot. I like all these movies a lot. I like Eddie a lot.
Yeah.
But it just happens to be the number 91 of my favorites.
Yeah,
my number one Yellow song of all time is no shock to anyone. It's called Strange Magic.
It's called Strange Magic.
Love everything about it. I like songs that build up.
Sure.
And you know the mellow start and then the way it rocks later in the song. It's just so good. This guy is a genius.
He's one of the most distinctive voices. And one of the most distinctive voices in music history.
Here's how my son looks at this. I can almost tell what he's thinking.
I don't think he
my
can.
My dad's over there talking about Jeff Lynne being a genius. What about my man Don Henley?
No, I don't really like to.
That's how you work.
I don't really like to ascribe genius to the arts as much. I probably should. That's probably a shortcoming of mine.
That's where a lot of genius is exhibited.
No, but
Mike?
You know who did the ceremony? I'm trying to think of the word. The induction ceremony speeches for Jeff Lynne. It was Joe Walsh and Tom Petty. That says something about
my
the
guys.
Genius of Jeff Lynne. Yeah. So.
One of my guys.
Yeah.
Well, I hope Tom Petty's one of your guys.
He's fine.
Oh my God. Well, you couldn't sound.
I like Tom Petty, but he doesn't. He's not in the mix with Joe Walsh.
Oh my
me.
God.
Oh, gosh. Well, I have to miss the last one on the way up there to slap.
Is this a surprise to you that I like the Eagles and their members more than I like Tom Petty?
It's not that you like the Eagles. That's perfectly acceptable, but
thank you.
Kind of demean and devalue Tom Petty in the process.
I love Tom Petty.
No, you don't. Okay. You don't love
yes,
him.
Yes, I do.
No, you
Wild
don't.
Flowers, one of my all-time favorite songs.
Let's get to Mike's number one
the
YouTube
waiting.
Channel. Please, Mike.
This is the only channel that I'm a Patreon to. I give a whopping $7 a month, not to brag, but I've fallen in love with this channel. It's called the WHY Files. And the Y Files looks at what could be things like Bigfoot, ghosts, UFOs, but he does it from a scientific, kind of a skeptic perspective and tells stories. And they usually last between 20 and 30 minutes with footage and research. And he comes on. If you can debunk them, he can. But he gives evidence to certain stories that is fascinating and extremely entertaining. And he's not some kind of a whack guy like the Art Bell thing, but it's quite entertaining. The Y Files.
Well, that's great stuff. And I can't tell you how many times when you mentioned Art Bell. I can't tell you how many times on the way back from a game that I covered or whatever, when I'm out driving through the night, how many times I listened to Art Bell and how that made the trip go quicker. So
it did.
Thanks for mentioning him.
I dreaded listening to
Art
Bell. Not entertaining to me.
Oh my God, Mike.
With current news and current history. I mean, the recent congressional hearings and so forth on UFOs and things like that, Art Bell may have been more in tune than what some of us give credit to. So maybe we should have
listened to
Art Bell.
It was entertaining. It was fun to listen to.
Yeah, I think so, too. I loved Art Bell.
All right, Mike, good stuff. We look forward to seeing your list on your Facebook
page. Did you do your
number one? Yeah, my number one was Strange Magic.
That's right.
Thank you, Mike.
I am surprised that Rollover Beethoven wasn't on your list, but that's okay.
Yeah, they have a lot of good songs, and I like Rollover Beethoven, but didn't make my list.
Yeah, that's okay. I get 10 kisses right, we'll out of it today. That's, I'm happy about that.
Well,
that's been good.
That's too far for us.
We'll see you next week.
Okay.
All right. Our friend Mike Furches.
Cross the line with that.
What?
10 kisses. Just kidding.
Well, he gets 10 kisses.
Good for him.
ELO. And arguably, the Heartbreakers were everything the Eagles were.
Mm.
Being real here. Okay?
Mm.
That's just a
arguably.
Matter. That's a matter of fact. If somebody came up to you on the street.
It's arguable and a matter of fact.
No, it's the fact that they're on the same level with the Eagles is not debatable. If somebody came up to you on the street and said, the Heartbreakers and the Eagles, I have a tough time choosing between them. You'd say, yeah, I get it. It's a tough choice. My preference would be the Eagles, but it's not a slam dunk.
What was the best song Mike Campbell sang for the Heartbreakers?
That doesn't matter.
It doesn't.
It doesn't matter.
So five lead singers to one doesn't matter.
That's a bonus for the Eagles, yes.
Big bonus.
But it doesn't mean they're a better band than the Heartbreakers.
Okay.
I mean, that's just a fact,
all
Jack.
Right. If I can sing harmony.
You know, the Rolling Stones have one lead singer.
Yeah, but Keith Richards sang a couple tunes.
A couple out of 5 million.
Well, Eagles are better than the Rolling Stones.
You really think you're gonna go that way?
Yeah.
Your defense. This is beyond being a fan.
No one knows what the Rolling Stones songs mean.
This is beyond being a fan.
I can't get no satisfaction. Can you imagine if Don Henley went up there and I can't get no? That's not a song that Don Henley would be caught dead trying to sing.
Yet Don Henley has paid huge. Kudos to the Rolling Stones and had Mick Jagger on his album Cass
Singing.
County. He doesn't like Mick?
No, which isn't, he was singing on Don Henley's album. He didn't just get to go up there and say, miss you.
That's your attempt at humor. You think that's funny?
Yeah.
Who else would?
Woo, woo! He didn't get to do that on Don Henley's
Sorry,
album.
Bob,
you're now saying
funny.
The Rolling Stones were an overrated band.
I didn't say that at all.
What are you saying?
I'm saying when Don Henley and Mick Jagger get together, we do things Don Henley's way. Mick Jagger.
Are you kidding?
Mick Jagger doesn't call those shots, my friend. Mick, you're singing this
Mick
verse.
Jagger would never. No offense to your boy, Don Henley. And he's kind of my boy till you got all weird. Because
Good.
You have gotten weird.
Good.
This is who's that guy, Jason Eady? This is like Jason Eady on steroids.
Well, no kidding, and it always has been. Go for
and
it.
And it's weird how you've gotten with this.
Yeah, you can call it whatever you want.
So you're discrediting the Eagles with
yeah,
all this.
You call it whatever you want.
It's too bad.
I'm not worried about it.
Because I'm working to get them to Wichita.
Well, get it
and
done,
And I want
then.
Them to Wichita.
Well, then make it happen.
But with you countering that with this, whatever this is, it's going to be tougher for me.
All right, good
You've
luck.
You've made my job more difficult.
That's okay.
And you're not going. I'm not taking you.
That's fine.
Yeah. I'm not taking you to see the Eagles in Wichita.
I don't need to go with you to see them.
I'm not about to.
Good.
I wouldn't be caught dead.
Fine.
Seeing the Eagles with you.
You know what? I'm not going to miss you. At that show.
Go ahead.
Woo, woo!
No, you know, we're trying it again.
Well, if we get a train on 13th Street on the way over, then yeah.
I don't understand it. But I'll guarantee you right now, this guy ain't paying for your ticket to see the
you
Eagles.
You know how many times I've paid for tickets to see the Eagles?
Well, it's just not happening.
And by the way...
I'm more likely to take...
The contribution that you promised to New York, I mean, am I going to have to take a lead pipe to the back of the knees, or what are we doing there?
I'm not wedded to that.
It sure sounded like you were.
No, that's when you were taking the...
No, it wasn't. That was to not
trailer.
Take the camper.
That's
no, that was to not take the camper.
Circumstances have changed. And if you keep asking...
That was to not take the camper and have a night of lodging.
Let me tell you what, if you keep bringing it up, the chances diminish.
Well, that's on you, man.
Yeah, I'll sleep.
Making a promise.
Remember what Jason Duda says? I'll sleep just fine.
Well, if you want to make promises to your child and then break them, then.
Child?
Yeah, what am I?
You're a grown adult.
I'm your child.
And if you need my money to make that trip, you shouldn't be making the trip.
Well, it would just help.
You going to help me on my next vacation?
Well, I didn't offer to, and I didn't tell the world
that
I would.
What if I ask you to? I need a little help when we head out on our next vacation.
I mean, you offered. It was unsolicited, and it seems like you should be a man of your word on that one.
Well, I would hope your wife would get you by the side and say, we don't need his help. We'll pull this off.
You're not afraid to take...
No, I trust me, I know.
Take a little assistance.
No, you're not. Believe me, that's the first thing I've agreed with you.
I mean, I don't see the problem with it. It's just money.
Well, then you should be able to handle it.
You want your kid to have a fun...
You should be able to handle it, right?
Yeah, you would think.
I don't know what's the matter with your equipment.
It's all good.
We will not be around tomorrow or Friday, but we will be back here on Monday. We're going to start talking some Big 12 football next week as we are right in the zone of college football, which starts a week from Saturday. And then, of course, the Labor Day weekend, it's in full force. We'll see you all Monday. Have a good weekend.